Hi, Michelle. Hi, Kayla. Thanks for coming in. Sorry about all the fuss. It's not normally like this. I can find you somewhere quieter, Michelle, where you can wait. I'll need to speak with Kayla on her own.
On her own?
I can organise you a cup of tea while you wait.
No. I'm her mother. I'm going to come in with her.
It's a technicality, Michelle, but if you're not supportive of Kayla's claim, which you've indicated you're not, then we need to speak to Kayla separately. A witness assistance officer will be with us the entire time looking after Kayla's welfare. Kayla, would you like to come with me? Kayla, can you tell me, well, when you were with that man at the truck stop, Kayla, whose idea was it for you to have sex with that man? Kayla, it's important for you to concentrate on the questions I'm asking.
Yes, important.
That's right. It's very important. So, tell me, whose idea was it for you to have sex with that man at the truck stop?
Daddy. Daddy said I could ride in the big truck and get a chubba chub.
If you had sex with the man? You do understand what sex is?
That's how you make babies.
Did you want to make a baby with that man at the truck stop?
He had yucky hands. Yucky hands that smell like petrol.
So why did you go with him to the toilets? Why did you let him touch you?
To get a chubba chub.
From Daddy, you said?
Yeah, Daddy.
Kayla, we're going to have to talk about exactly where the man touched you. Is that all right?
He broke my shirt.
Broke your shirt?
My favourite. The one with the fairy on it.
You mean he ripped it?
It had a fairy on it. Do you like fairies? I love fairies. They fly so high they can go wherever they feel like.
What did you score from Lady Tracy?
Two mentions, directions hearing. Oh, and this one. Some lunatic who wants to blow up Woolies needs to see his mum before she dies. So they're getting Rosenberg back for a bail application.
Back from his holidays?
I know. Shoot me now.
Julie's gonna hate you.
Rosenberg should just get a fill-in. I don't know why he's drag her back.
Because he can't take a shit without Julie there to hand him the paper. Plus, she's had this Lao trip planned for weeks.
You know her schedule intimately.
We're friends.
Chat around the court, maybe coffee friends or friends with more personal benefits?
Well, considering I'm a gentleman, I don't think I'll be answering that sort of question.
I thought so.
Hey, I'm not confirming or denying anything, but I do have a Rosenberg tip. Apparently, he's got a thing for hot young lawyers. I reckon you should bang him.
You are so helpful to have around.
You betcha. My friend, yet another fabulously drafted indictment. Not my words, Janet's. How are we going on the next few?
We are done.
Well, that's $50 a brief, so that's 1, 2, 3. There's 150. Thank you, good sir. Let me show you something spectacular.
No, don't use my computer to get onto Facebook.
I like you don't check it 10 times a day.
I'm not on Facebook.
That's right. Why is that? Moral objection to social networking, or are you just a cynic?
Well, I just don't have any burning need to get in touch with people I never liked at uni.
Well, maybe if those uni people looked like this. Say hello to my Friday night.
Do you actually know this girl?
Harriet? Yeah, we did first year law together in Sydney. And I'm going to swing it so my grandfather lends me his old Jag. She's got a thing for doing a little vintage.
Okay, I have got my first ever court appearance today. I just got the case and I'm totally unprepared. Plus, I'm still trying to get a hold of this pirate sex case.
Pirate sex, okay, do tell.
Can you please?
What, are you freaking out? You freaking out?
No.
Okay, there are things you can take for that.
I'm not freaking out. why am I not surprised there's a pharmacy in your pocket?
Well, they're just beta blockers, you know, help calm the nerves. Take a couple before court and you will cruise through.
Oh, yeah, my cousin takes those before auditions, so he's really... he's an actor.
Rock on.
Would I have seen him in anything, your cousin?
Oh, no, he never gets any work.
Encouraging.
Can I ask what Kayla was doing on that drive with your husband? Does she often accompany him in the truck?
This is ridiculous.
Ridiculous? Your daughter may have been sexually abused.
Joel's a good man. You know, he loves Kayla.
Did Kayla ever talk to you about the drawings she made at school?
Those bloody drawings. Why don't these teachers just mind their own business?
When a student like Kayla makes drawings like that of a man on top of a girl with white liquid spraying out his penis, it becomes a mandatory reporting issue.
Yeah, it's making trouble, that's what that's doing. You know, kids draw stuff.
She told the teacher the drawing was of her. She said it's what happened to her the night she went in the truck with her father.
Mm-hmm. Did she also tell you that she's got a dragon living under her bed? Oh, yeah, that's a frequent topic of conversation at our house.
But a graphic drawing like that, how would she know even what that was if it hadn't happened to her?
Oh, because kids talk about stuff in the playground. You know, if Kayla gets something into her brain, it's real for her.
You do realise the medical report confirms Kayla's no longer a virgin?
Yeah, well, for all I know, she could have lost that ages ago. Look, her brain may not be up to scratch, but she's a teenage girl. She's got teenage girl hormones. You know, she hangs around with boys at school. I'm just grateful she hasn't gotten pregnant yet.
You won't even consider it's possible she's telling you the truth.
I'm a mother. A mother knows.
Michelle, I understand how difficult it is to imagine your own husband being part of something like this, but I don't see how you can ignore what she's saying.
Because she's making it up.
If a sexual assault has occurred, we will be proceeding.
You know what? There have been people like you sticking their oar in ever since she was born. Why don't you just mind your own business? Go and save someone else.
Julie, heard about your holiday stuff up?
I should be passing Swedish backpackers right now.
Well, Rosenberg's freakishly attached to you.
And I was freakishly attached to my holiday in Laos.
Well, could be worse. Could be in our office today.
I bet it's happy days in there.
Yeah. Now, I've got 10 minutes till I need to be in court, so how about we get creative?
10 minutes?
I didn't say creative.
How about tomorrow night? I think we're going to need a little bit more than 10 minutes, don't you?
Tomorrow? Tomorrow's Friday.
Well done.
No, I mean... Well, is it such a great idea for us to be, you know... together, in public, consider. You know.
As opposed to in private, like now?
Yeah.
Considering what?
Well, maybe we shouldn't be drawing attention to ourselves. How about Saturday? Or Saturday morning, even? I've got some very pleasant ways of saying good morning.
You know what I hate most about lawyers?
What?
You're all so full of shit.
Julie, wait.
No, fuck the hell off, Ben.
Jimmy, it's Erin O'Shaughnessy again. How do you expect to get any new stories if you don't ever answer your phone? For the 100th time, call me when you get a second. Please tell me that's not breakfast.
You'd be surprised what food colouring does for the synapses. You been busy?
There's a memorandum of advice and a draft indictment for you to sign. I'm not even bothering with whoever the man was who paid for sex from Kayla. The case is too hard to run if she can't identify who she had sex with. We charge her father with soliciting.
And when the defence says she invented the whole story?
She hasn't. She's telling the truth.
The truth isn't an issue. This girl's brain damaged. She can't give any evidence that's even remotely credible to a jury.
I understood the problem last time, but this girl can talk, Tony. She's talked to me, and I believe her. In the memo, I've set out the way a court can assess the reliability of a brain-damaged victim, and there's some articles from a few psychological journals, and there's a psychiatrist's paper there too on how a damaged brain perceives truth and lies and recalls events. We'd have to call an expert witness, a psych who could explain it all to a jury.
I can't sign this.
You don't approve the charge? Why not?
Aaron, we don't have the truck driver who paid this girl for sex.
I know, but that's why I said...
Without that man's confession, all we do have is the word of the father who denies any of this ever happened against the word of a brain-damaged girl.
What about the drawing?
So what?
Do you have an aversion to going to trial?
I have an aversion to losing.
Make the father sweat it out in court. He pimped his daughter out for $100, for God's sake.
The girl's own mother says we can't trust a word she says.
Who wants to admit their own husband could do this? Come on, Tony, it happened.
The girl says it happened.
This is exactly the kind of case we should be running. We're supposed to be looking after the public interest. We should be trying to get a conviction.
Have you considered what that might actually mean to Kayla?
A life free of enforced prostitution?
Docs would get involved and they'll have no hesitation removing her from her mother if they think she failed to protect her. You'd be taking her away from her own family.
Why do you think the mother's so uptight? Now, Aaron, you're so caught up in this girl's cause, you presume we'll prosecute the father no matter what. It's all very earnest.
And that memo jumps so far into the admissibility of evidence that we may never even get from Kayla. I'm sorry, there's no chance of success at trial.
Next time I get dumped with Tony Gillies, I'm going to do it. I'm going to tell him to his face he's an old fucking wanker.
Yeah, mention his dandruff too while you're at it.
He didn't even look at all the work I'd done. Just sat there in his foul-looking suit, eating his foul-looking donut.
Well, he's not going to take it to trial.
Says it won't even make it through a committal.
Ew! Richard's status update.
I didn't think Richard was on Facebook.
Bad choice of profile pic.
There's nothing like waking up with a boner.
No way.
I hope you didn't have any plans for the weekend. You've been knee-deep in this.
Oh, the Mervich case. The one with the guy who got bashed with the bolt cutters.
Don't get too excited. You're doing the preliminary work only. Just a summary of the issues.
Yeah, of course. Thanks, Tracy.
The case will be everywhere.
I thought you would have given it to Ben for sure.
Might be losing his touch.
Just relax. Think calm. You can do it.
Okay.
Don't stress. You still have 15 minutes before you need to be there.
The judge is going to know it's my first time.
Aren't you taking this?
Well, I don't need the botanist certificate, do I?
Of course you do. It proves that the substance found in the accused's possession was actually cannabis.
Of course it was cannabis.
It still has to be proven. Without the certificate from the police botanist, the defence could argue that it was anything, parsley.
I'm not ready for this, am I?
You know the case backwards. You just need to slow down and relax.
Mm-hmm.
Did you take any of those beta blockers?
Mm-mm.
Maybe you should. Drugs Act 2. It's always good to have the legislation.
Why are you so onto it, Tatum?
You will learn, Richard, that I'm onto everything. What would you do without me?
Thank you. So, once you get into the witness box and you bow to the judge and I ask you what you were doing that day, you are going to tell them you were...
At work in the pharmacy.
Right, and that you saw...
The long-haired boy with the skull tattoo holding little red balloons full of hash outside the high school.
Perfect.
To sell to the kids, same as he does every day.
No.
No?
It's not important what he does every other day.
Not important?
Well, no, they only care what he did and had in his possession on that particular day.
But this boy is a drug dealer. He sells drugs to teenage children. Surely they care about that.
Well, no, see, they've only charged him with possession.
He sells drugs. Then he is a drug dealer. He should go to jail.
Yeah, but if the police had maybe found him with a little bit more hash, it would be a different story. But, well, you see, with drugs, the law only cares about quantity, but you don't need to worry about any of this.
Are you all right?
Yeah, I'm just a bit hot.
And nothing but the truth.
There is no need to bow. It is customary for lawyers and police to bow on entering and leaving a courtroom, not witnesses. Perhaps your lawyer neglected to inform you.
I am exceptionally sorry, Your Honour. My mistake. Would you please state your name and...
I can't hear you.
Once again, I do apologise, Your Honour. would you please state your name...
I can't hear you.
Would you please state
Mr.
your
Sterling,
name...
Mr. Sterling, I can't hear you.
Where is your tie? Your tie.
Oh, I crave the court's indulgence, to appear before you inappropriately attired.
Would someone find this man a tie? Here we are. Thank you, sir. The court is grateful.
Thank you.
Take your time. You do know how to tie a tie.
Yes, Your Honor.
Round you go. Now I can hear you. Proceed.
Mrs. Salim, is it true that you were working in your pharmacy?
Mr. Sterling?
Yes, Your Honor.
Is your witness a letterbox?
No, Your Honor, she's a pharmacist.
I will not continue until you have explained to your witness that she must remove her hijab.
Your Honor, strictly speaking, it's not a hijab. When only the eyes are visible, it's referred to as a burqa.
Whatever it is, I'd like it removed. Mr. Sterling, you are, of course, aware you are forbidden to talk to a witness while they're in the middle of giving evidence.
Is the heating in here up too high?
Are we having a moment?
No.
I'm going to stand this case down until after lunch while you attend to yourself, Mr. Sterling. I expect you back here at 2:15 with your witness, ready to proceed. Next.
Are you an asthmatic?
Yes, but...
Why don't you use your puffer?
I haven't had an attack in 4 years.
Well, you're having one now. There's a hospital emergency around the corner. They'll give you a nebulizer. No, this way. This way.
Sorry. Been flat out.
Obviously.
So, what's it like in the office? Janet's head on a plate yet?
I'm not giving you any dirt, Jimmy.
Hey, you called me. Lots.
I just want to know if I said anything. At the Christmas party. Anything? About the AG? About Janet's memo? Any of that stuff?
I'm not going to reveal my source.
Oh, give me a break. The police are all over the place at work.
Relax, Erin. You didn't say a word.
No? Nothing?
It wasn't you that showed me the file.
Oh, thank God. I don't suppose you want to tell me you did.
So you must have been seriously drunk to think you'd pinch a police file and show it to a journalist.
I'm a lawyer. Getting smashed was practically part of my degree.
So you don't remember much? You and me sneaking up to your office? Dancing naked on your desk to Beyonce?
Stop. Oh, God. Stop.
Can't exactly have been transcendental if you don't even remember it.
Can we just forget any of this ever happened? Please?
I might be able to get through to him. Actually, I've just got to just jump in here for a second. Yeah, obviously. You mind if I disturb you?
Oh, of course not, Detective Campbell.
I believe you're in looking after the bolt cutter babes.
That's the official police term for the Mervich case, is it? I thought it was still unclear who bashed him.
That's not, not exactly bedtime reading.
No.
And the pictures are,
Yeah, they are.
If you have any questions, you know, want anything clarified, just give me a bell.
Cool, I will, thanks.
I'm always happy to help you light up your strike rate.
So this is another case you just think is black and white, is it?
The evidence is pretty clear. I mean, the guy was living in the middle of nowhere with two crazy sisters who belted him dead with a bolt cutter.
If only it were that simple.
It is.
Richard, hi. She what?
Thanks for coming. I really need your help.
Ah, Richard, you've got to be joking. She's not going to listen to me just because I'm Muslim.
Mrs. Salim, this is my colleague Lena. Lena, Noor Salim.
Hi. Judge Walker was in one of her moods, I hear.
She was completely rude.
She can be difficult.
And racist. Would she say a nun had to remove her habit? Expect more understanding from a woman.
We have to be back there in 13 minutes.
I'm not going back. Why can't I write it down? Then you can read to her everything I saw.
Because it's crucial the judge hear it from you, Mrs. Salim. She needs to hear and see you're telling the truth.
Of course I'm telling the truth.
Well, how can a judge know that? Look, I understand the significance of the burqa, but seeing your whole face, seeing the truth in it, that's what will convince the judge.
You think nobody lies if you can see their face?
All I'm saying is this is how you can get the guy convicted. It's how you can personally stop him from walking around with drugs, which you know he's selling to children.
Lena, that's an Arabic name.
Yeah, it is.
They're missing me?
My family's Muslim. I'm not practicing.
That's a shame.
We have to be back there in 12 minutes.
How much was my coffee?
Why? Well, where are you going?
I think it's best I go home.
No, but the judge is waiting.
Send apologies from the letterbox. I'm not sure you should say you understand the significance of the burqa.
Wait, please.
You appear to be missing something, Mr. Sterling. May I ask, where is your witness?
I'm afraid she's gone.
Gone?
Unfortunately, yes.
I take it until she comes back, you'll be moving on to your second witness, the police informant.
Well, I did assume that Mrs. Salim would take all day, so I don't exactly have the police informant lined up at this time.
You're telling me you now have no witness? I've a good mind to strike this out, Mr. Sterling.
No witness. No puffer. No police informant. No. No, in fact, and regrettably, I have not a single thing I should have. Not one. Brilliant. I do apologise sincerely. Oh, great one. Your Honour. Goodbye.
Next.
Crown versus Dixon, Your Honour.
Oh, great one.
What was that? I can't hear you.
Tracy is everywhere.
You're not supposed to give them to people with asthma.
You didn't tell me you have asthma.
You didn't ask. Oh, and thanks no one for telling me I'd forgotten my tie.
Go away.
Okay, we won't talk about it. But can we talk about that setup underneath your desk?
What are you doing looking under my desk?
Trying to find out where the musty smell was coming from.
It's just my running shoes.
Not the pillow, the swag, or the aftershave? How long have you been sleeping here?
2 weeks, 3 days, 7 hours.
Didn't you buy a place in Camperdown?
Oh, the tenant won't leave. I don't know what else to do. I've tried everything. Eviction letters. Well, really just eviction letters, but he just won't respond. I don't know.
But it's your home. I could send a few guys over there to point that out to him.
Maybe not.
Why don't you go to a hotel?
I tried that for 3 weeks. Do you know how expensive it is to live in a hotel?
Well, you can't stay here. You need some good temporary accommodation. Luckily, I can help.
I can't believe you guys live here.
Believe it.
Why can't you live in your own place, Richard?
Did you offer Richard a beer?
Oh, no, that's okay.
So do I have to worry about you and this nerd?
I had an idea about pirate sex.
Yeah?
Sorry. You two talk about sex.
Work sex. It's Richard's case. It's legal, honey.
Oh, thanks.
So the first guy would dress up in a pirate costume when they had sex because that's how the second guy liked to orgasm, right?
Right. Are you okay?
Oh, he's fine. He just drinks too fast. And the second guy admits that he had this, like, mega orgasm.
Which is how they claim it can't be rape.
But who's to say that the orgasm couldn't just be a body thing?
Like an involuntary response to the pirate costume.
Well, why not? The orgasm itself doesn't actually say anything about consent. I could be all, and still have not given you consent to have sex with me.
Maybe we shouldn't be discussing this here.
Oh, no, Con's cool. Aren't you, baby?
Yeah. I'm cool.
Bueno.
Detective?
Come in.
I'm sorry to bother you at home, Detective.
That's all right.
I know we had a bit of a difference of opinion earlier on.
That's, it's nothing new.
But I still have some questions.
I see. What sort of questions? Are you worried about this?
Are you?
Not when you do that, no. But I know there's a lot of pressure on you guys right now.
Oh, I'm so sick of hearing about that file.
They could have 6 months worth of our emails, phone transcripts, and we could be under surveillance right now. And cameras.
Well, we better make it look good then. Do what we want, see we own our eyes only. Reminisce on the old days, keep an eye on the foundation that we laid down. Miss Bedea.
Since we all have so much time, perhaps you'd like me to inform you how pleased my wife is to be enjoying the familiar environs of Pymble this morning instead of wandering the Ponte Vecchio.
Your Honour, as we've heard, the accused is charged with suspected terrorism against a Woolworths supermarket in Trilby. According to his statement given to police, Mr. Bellis has devoted several months to building a homemade incendiary bomb designed to set fire to the contraceptives aisle.
You may not be responsible for calling this hearing, Miss Bedea, but right now you're certainly prolonging it.
Your Honour, the defence has brought this application because the accused's mother is in intensive care at St. Vincent's Hospital with a heart condition. The defence has suggested that she may pass within the week, though this, of course, is speculative.
Thank you for the philosophical touch.
The accused is, in our opinion, a flight risk, Your Honour, and we oppose his application for bail to be with his mother over the following days. Constable Munir, would you care to tell the court what happened when you arrived on the scene of the accused's home on the day of December 12?
Mr. Bellis was in his garage experimenting with a small homemade bomb.
And would you tell the court what Mr. Bellis was wearing?
Nothing. He was naked, except for some rosary beads.
Do you recall what Mr. Bellis said to you?
I wouldn't forget it. He said, "I'm going to blow up every single one of those atheists."
Yes?
I don't like to say the C word in the presence of ladies, Your Honour.
There are no ladies present, only lawyers.
Well, if I may beg to differ, Your Honour, I'm quite sure I am, in fact, a lady. At least that was the case last time I checked.
Quite right.
Sterling, I'm Detective Karen Liu.
Oh, right. Now?
Yeah.
Okay. I'm not really into clubs. When they all said they were going to the Cross, I just called it a night.
Anyone accompany you home?
No.
Where exactly is your home?
Now or at the time of the Christmas party?
The Christmas party?
My office.
I'm sorry?
I was living in my office.
You're not the owner of number 74 Olive Street, Camperdown?
I'm having tenant issues. It's a long story.
Okay. So you spent the entire night here?
That's right.
Alone?
Yep. Well, actually, no.
Yep or no?
I could tell there was a light on from one of the other offices and I could hear some music and singing.
And you didn't get up to see who it was?
Well, no, then they'd know I was here too.
According to your swipe card, you next left the building at 5 a.m.
Yeah, I got an egg and bacon roll from Burke Street. Look, I know you need to do your investigation, but you're not going to tell anyone I was sleeping under my desk, are you?
You're in a relationship, Richard.
No, I'm not. I mean, I have been, but I'm not now. Sorry. Why the personal questions? I thought this was about the file on the Attorney General.
Do you use social networking? Maybe as a way to find women? Or to provide amusement for your mates?
No, I'm not on Facebook or Twitter or any of that waste of time. Who needs to know your personal stuff every second?
But you do have a Facebook page.
No, I'm not on Facebook.
So you didn't write this update yesterday morning? I'm the mole, Quinn's the pig.
Hey, can you stretch this out for me?
I'm a big man with a small penis, and there's nothing like waking up with a boner.
Well, here's a man that needs a Christmas break.
You've been impersonating me on Facebook?
And who knew you'd have 28 friends? And that's after a couple of days. You give me a month, and I'll get you 100 at least.
Why didn't you friend me?
Impersonating someone is an offence. And saying Quinn's a pig and I'm the mite, I should sue you for defamation, quite apart from the fact that the police are now totally sus about me.
It was just a joke, Richard.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, hilarious. Write your own indictments from now on.
Look, they don't actually think it was you.
Why, at the very least, they think I'm some kind of anarchist.
If they're checking Facebook, what else are they checking?
Maybe our personal emails and phone calls.
I'm going to go delete my porn.
Detective Sergeant Karen Liu. This is Detective Senior Constable Alan Moretti. Have a seat. So let's start with what time you left the Christmas party. Of course, we know what happens at these parties, drinking, dancing.
You probably weren't looking at the clock.
No.
But approximately?
10, maybe 10:30.
Did you leave the party alone?
No, I live with Julie Russo. She's a judge's associate we work with.
Okay. So where'd you go after you left?
Back here, actually. There wasn't much food at the party and I was hungry. I ordered a pizza. There's not exactly a generous catering budget around here.
Do you two discuss the file on the Attorney General?
If I remember correctly, the bulk of the conversation was on the topic of bonobos.
Bonobos?
What's a bonobo?
It's a monkey, isn't it? I guess that sort of thing comes up all the time in the Department of Public Prosecution.
Well, this place, you know, full of David Attenborough fans.
So you ate the pizza here with Julie, and then what?
Went back to my place.
So what time did Julie leave your place? Was it that night, or...?
I dropped her home around 7 the next morning.
7? Wow, that's resilience. God, you wouldn't see me up at 7 the morning after a Christmas party.
Me either.
Well, I didn't want the world to know that we'd spent the night together. Oh.
No, I suppose you're used to having things you don't want the world to know.
How's that?
That drugs possession charge last year? Impressive you avoided a conviction. Lucky you're with the right family, eh, for pulling strings? Your dad even set you up in the job here, right? You'd owe him a hell of a big thank you for that.
You'll be missing one of these.
And I'm late. Did you get the feeling you picked the wrong profession?
Maybe you're just really bad at driving wheelie bags. Well, I hope at least it's exciting, the thing you're running late for.
Try depressing. Tony Gillies wants me to nolly a case that should be going to trial.
And why isn't it?
Well, it's easier to let a bastard get away with soliciting his brain-damaged daughter than try him for it.
It's the Truckee case. Yeah. Well, I read about that. It sounded like it had a shot.
It did. Well, what do I know?
Don't tell me you still have a heart.
Shameful, right?
You know they'll try and beat that out of you.
Could you please state your name?
It's Joel Brennan, and you can all fuck right off.
Hey. What are you watching?
Kayla's dad.
I thought you nollied that case.
Changed my mind.
I'm not answering anything for you cocksuckers.
Nice guy.
One sexy machine.
One day she'll be all yours, Benny.
Yeah, well, how about tonight?
Tonight?
I've got a date.
When haven't you? What's wrong with people? I'm nearly 80 and I can read that to save a parking sign. Give me your keys, mate.
What are you doing?
I'm gonna park this idiot in.
Once a cop, always a cop.
That'll teach a bastard a lesson.
Hey, I thought you were staying in tonight.
I had a better idea. I bought a few little things for Kayla.
You don't think she has pajamas?
Maybe not pretty ones.
Or pencils or puzzles?
Look, her life can't get any worse.
And a suitcase of presents is going to help how?
If I can get Michelle to like me and trust me, she'll realise that there are people out there who want to help her. And if she stops thinking she has to rely on her husband, she might think about being a witness in court.
Don't you think that's a bit manipulative? Erin, can you just stop for a second and think about this? You plan on doing this for everyone who doesn't get what they want. Erin, the suitcase fairy. It's so inappropriate.
Oh, it's always something inappropriate, isn't it? This, the file, Jimmy Butcher. You know what? I asked him about that. It wasn't me.
Well, what's he going to say? That he scooped his big story from a chatty one-night stand?
You haven't said a word about where you were the night the file was leaked. When you change your mind about that, I'd love to hear.
You lot are getting flogged over this business with the Attorney General.
Tell me about it.
Make sure the cops got no reason to come after you.
They already interviewed me, they got nothing.
Cocky bastard.
Well, there's nothing to get.
If they think you're not being straight with them over one thing, they think you're lying about everything.
You think I'm lying? Is that right?
Hey, your father's made no secret about what he thinks of the AG.
So suddenly everyone thinks I'm going to bust my balls for Dad. Is that right?
I'm just saying the devil's in the details, son. And details are where people get tripped up. Understand?
Get another round.
Oi. Are you the prick who parked me in?
That spot's reserved for people with disabilities.
Benny, you've
Julie Russo, please well, leave a message.
I can't fucking move my car now, can I?
What if I've been in a wheelchair? Did you consider that?
You want to have a go, old man?
Hey, what's going on? Is there a problem here?
I have to swim a mile before my heart rate even looks at 90. See, you'll find out I'm not just some old man when your face hits the floor, son.
Hey, whoa, hey, calm down, Pop, all right?
Come, bugger off. You just have to wait, sonny.
You okay?
Hey, you?
I didn't just get threatened by some meathead, Pop.
No, you got hassled by the cops. You can't let them think you took the law into your own hands.
Yeah, because we McMahons never do that, do we?
Is there anything at all they can trip you up on? Fix it. Pronto.
Hi there, you've called Julie Russo. Please leave a message.
Julie, it's Ben. I know you don't want to hear from me after today, but if you can please call me back. And if the police want to talk to you, maybe don't mention exactly what we got up to on the night of the Christmas party, because I didn't mention it. And really, they don't need to know everything, do they? Julie, you really need to call me. I'm on your street and I can't remember which one's your house. There's a cream terrace, right? Shit, Harriet. Shit.
Aren't you going out anywhere?
No, I'm too tired.
Well, you can't stay here. It's Friday night.
Oh, why not? That's a great TV for watching movies.
Why don't you hang out with us? Con's work lent him the Lotus for the weekend.
Oh, really?
Yeah, you heard the man.
I'm happy here.
Yeah, he's happy here.
Richard, you need me in your life. Now, come on.
Tell her you've got plans. And the Lotus is yours.
Michelle. Hi.
Erin. Has something happened?
No, no, not at all. It's just... Is it okay if I come in?
Yeah. Done here. Swatch up all that stuff.
Hi, Kayla. It's Erin. Brought you some presents. If that's all right.
Presents?
Can't say no now, can I? Yeah.
Oh. Wow. Oh, cool.
Look, Kayla. A fairy shirt.
Ah, no fairies. Not unless you want to be here or not.
Well, I wanted to replace Kayla's T-shirt. You know the fairy one, the one that got ripped?
No, I don't know what she's told you, but I've never bought her a fairy shirt.
Kayla, your shirt. Your favourite one, remember? You said it broke.
What are you doing telling people you need new clothes, love?
I'm afraid she's played you there.
Doesn't it concern you that because of you, this victim will never receive justice?
Excuse me.
What you've done is put us right back on the front page.
Can you hold that?
Hi, Con. It's Richard.
Can you just tell her that I'll be home at about 6?
Can you pass me my bra?
They've asked me to take on the Murvich case. I'm sorry.
Well, why you?
I'm the idiot who put you on the case.
Hi there. You've called Julie Russo. Please leave a message.
Why did you tell them that?
Because that's what happened.
Julie, are you
kidding? I'm not going to lie to the police, Ben. I work for a judge.
Hey, what's going on? Is there a problem here?
There was some kind of verbal altercation involving a disabled parking space.
Fuck!
I fucked everything.
Join us for Crownies again next week. Tomorrow, the forensic pathologists are back as hospital staff are under suspicion in a new series of Silent Witness. 8:30 tomorrow night on ABC One.
What do I do? What am I to do? What do I do? What am I to do? What do I do? What do I do?